Hello, my name is Artur Rahimov, and in this video I want to share with you one interesting observation which relates to adaptation to ketosis. And it's known in ketogenic communities since there are millions of people around the world who switch to low-carb diets during recent years. These diets are very popular these days. It's known that it takes quite a while for them to adapt to a new energy source. Why? Because ordinary people and ordinary diet, it's heavily based on carbohydrates. So it rises blood glucose, and glucose is used as a main fuel. And when people make a transition to, let's say, some low-carb, ketogenic, therapeutic ketogenic diet, maybe carnivore diet or PKD, paleolithic ketogenic diet, for example, for all these diets, the level of carbohydrates is really low. It can be like 20 grams, 10 grams, sometimes nothing, zero carbs at all in diet. And people who teach this diet, and we of course monitor the students, the patients sometimes, because thousands of doctors these days use low carb diets as well, we observe that it takes a while for the patients to adapt to this diet, and usually it takes about 2-3 weeks before the level of ketones in blood starts to rise, because normally we have like somewhere around maybe 30-50 times less ketones in terms of energy value, and so glucose level is very high, and that's why our body relies on glucose. But when we make a transition to a diet which has no glucose, it's like maybe very similar to fasting. When you start fasting on water, for example, it takes a while to adapt, as it is believed. But what I found many years ago, I've been teaching breathing retraining for about 20 years now, but I knew already like more than 15 years ago that when I achieved a certain level of breathing, and later I found that many of our students also have this effect when they require virtually no time to make a transition. So when I achieve a certain level of health, which is manifested here in 60 seconds for the body oxygen test, maybe I'll explain a little bit later this table for people who are new, because I also want to, like, people who are interested in this diet, like how it's possible to achieve this interesting effect, like people in hours or sometimes almost instantaneously or very easily can adapt to ketosis without this suffering, which is again like relates to so-called ketoflu symptoms. People get headaches, people get nausea, people get insomnia, sleeping problems, irritability and low energy levels, which makes sense because low level of glucose in blood gets towards the lowest minimum, maybe even below the norm, and ketones are still very low, maybe 0.1, 0.2, even like 0.3 millimoles per deciliter. It's still too little. People would be likely to suffer from a kind of inability to think clearly, and physical energy would be also low, like the desire to exercise, to function, like to be physically active would be very, very low. When we get maybe about 1 and especially 2-3 or higher levels of ketones, in again millimoles per deciliter, only then we kind of get real vitality in the bodies. So how does it relate to our breath? I started to talk about the situation with me because again, like when I achieved 60 seconds for the body oxygen test, and later I realized that virtually all our students, that I asked practitioners whom I trained, like who also get 50-60 seconds for the body oxygen test in the morning, they also report the same experience, meaning that if they had, for example, ordinary carbohydrate diet, like with a lot of carbs on one day, and let's say next morning we decide to cut out all carbs, maybe have like 10 grams or 5 grams of carbs or no carbs at all, we actually adapt to this diet virtually instantaneously because we don't experience any of these weird symptoms. So what happens here, I believe that at this level, our body function kind of more in a way as it was designed by nature. So instead of having these 2-3 weeks of misery, it's actually possible, but it's kind of a hard way, and I'm going to explain a little bit again for new people who does not know how it works. What is the kind of additional factor which makes transition to ketosis way easier? And the same factor can also make, of course, transition to keto adaptation or transition to ketosis way more difficult. If we look at kind of Mrs. Buteyko table of health zones, and what it tells us about how heavy is our breath, how much we breathe, because medical norm would be somewhere in the middle here. This is line health level 5, which corresponds to physiological norms for breathing established 100 years ago. And so it was common 100 years ago for people to have 40-50 seconds for the body oxygen test. 12 breaths a minute would be normal breathing frequency at rest for a 70-kilogram person. And at this level, actually, people would have also very easy adaptation to ketosis. As we know, it may be only somewhere maybe 1 or 2 days. So it's way easier to adapt to ketosis when people at this level. At this level, it virtually takes hours, and very possible at better level of health, high level of health, people just virtually like instantaneously adapt to ketosis if they want to use one fuel for the body, like for certain periods of times. It can be like whatever, weeks, days, even years. And then they need to switch to another fuel source, for example, to fats. They would do it virtually instantaneously. And so my experience, like I mentioned at the beginning about my own situation, I knew that like already 15 years ago when I never heard about low carbs or ketogenic diets, that when I achieved this level, sleep gets to 4 hours, as it's again very common for our students, like 4 hours of natural sleep, that if I skip a breakfast, like I feel totally normal. That was like kind of looks strange, because like normally people would need to eat breakfast to have energy. And why? Because the amount of energy which is can be taken from carbs usually just lasts for some hours, or for, let's say for several hours in our liver, glycogen in muscles, so it's very limited. And we have like, let's say, 100 times or more sources of energy stored in the form of fat. But it's difficult to adapt to this source. Like commonly people again say like you need 2-3 weeks of keto flu, of like kind of suffering to adapt to that. Or you may do like 3-day water fast, and during these 3 days it actually takes time for body to adapt, and that adaptation during water fast may also take like again quite considerable amount of time. But again, at easy breathing states when people have a lot of oxygen in the body, this adaptation is very fast. Now, what happens with us, and that's the reason why all these like doctors, health professionals, nutritionists, and people like who promote ketogenic diet, like it's of course very popular. Probably in last like 5 years, it was the biggest kind of change in health, in alternative health as well. That actually so many people, millions of people, adopted low carb ketogenic diets. But what happens with our breath during last 100 years? We know that people now breathe about twice more than we used to breathe 100 years ago. And if you want to see research how people breathe, I'm talking about normal subjects, how healthy people breathe, how people who have chronic diseases, like what are the numbers, let's say, for minute ventilation, you can open homepage normalbreathing.org, normalbreathing.org, and you can see the big table, historical graph. There is like video with explanation of breath holding times results for this body oxygen test, which shows you kind of more details. So what we know now is that actually modern people have somewhere around 20 seconds for the body oxygen test, and these are relatively healthy people. Let's say 20, 22, probably would be somewhere around 60-70% of people would be there. If people are sick and or they suffer from various, again, diseases of civilization or lifestyle diseases, so-called non-contagious disease, we would have even less than 20 seconds for the body oxygen test because of a heavy breathing. So we can have maybe 10 seconds, 15 seconds for the body oxygen test. And then people have many medications. We are usually more sick, having very variety of various symptoms. We would have even heavier breathing and less oxygen in the body, so close to death. And these people may need even longer time to adapt to ketosis. So what happens here is following in our understanding, because like again, people with ketogenic community has this strong belief that everybody needs 2-3 weeks, and or it's very normal to have like these 2-3 weeks to adapt to ketosis. And what I'm saying, actually, it relates only to the group of people who are within this health level. So health level here, let's say somebody who has health level 2 or 2.5, like 10, 15 seconds, I believe these people would need this long amount of time. Somebody who has even level 3, very possible that we still require like many days to adapt to ketosis. But as I already mentioned here, is if somebody has health level 6 or 7 at this level, adaptation to ketosis takes probably some either hours, or people may not even notice. It's really easy. They may feel like maybe a little bit less energy for a few hours maybe a little bit nausea, maybe some very light headache for a short period of time. But again, if they have a next meal which has provide them fats and we eat this meal already several hours later, we would be feeling a lot of energy, we would be able to exercise, we would not have problems with sleep, and so on and so forth. Therefore, it's kind of interesting observation that actually current situation, again, when 2-3 weeks of keto flu is a norm, relates to the situation when people have low body oxygen level and the breathing is too heavy. Dr. Kutejka believed actually that with each health level, dozens, probably hundreds of chemical reactions change either dramatically or to the extent so that we maybe not completely, some chemical reaction can go in the opposite order. And therefore, it makes sense that actually when our breath is heavy and heavy, various mechanisms which allows the body to use fat as a main energy source, we get either suppressed, repressed, or kind of again like start to move in the opposite direction. And that makes adaptation to ketosis, of course, very difficult for people. And I believe therefore that actually breathing retraining has like such a big potential as well for people who are in ketogenic community to explore kind of this technique, this method, because with breathing retraining, people can experience amazing benefits. We know that we can defeat any health problem when people achieve Dr. Kutejka golden standard for health. And again, cancer, diabetes, virtually again, any health conditions can be solved. And therefore, I invite people to explore more kind of this idea, to study how our breathing retraining can help us to adapt to ketosis.